lot of you guys were asking me a lot of questions on how to add server. I mean, how to add commands to your Minecraft server. Not as in adding your own commands, but how to use commands on your server. And I had lots of difficulties in answering some of them, so I'll quickly go through that video type today and show you more things you can also add to your Minecraft server, or things you can also do, as in some of the commands you can access using your server. So if you move on to Chrome and you have started your server, make sure your server has been started. So right now I am playing with my brother. He's using a different PC and I'm also using this PC. Alright, so the server is online, as you can see. So now if I move over here to options, no sorry, if I move over here to console. Alright, so right now I am on the console. So these are some of the commands or some of the chats running through the game as at now, and I am also in the game. Okay, so now first of all, before you can use the commands, you must become an operator, when being is that it's your own server, so you must rule your own server, as you know. So as I said, if you want to do that, first of all, when you first create a server and you start it, you won't be an operator, so you can't use commands. So all you have to do is to type in the /op, then your username. So my username is Addison. Then I just type in Addison and I enter. But right now I'm already an operator, so it says nothing changed. The player is already an operator. So that if you do yours, it will say made maybe your name into brackets an operator. Okay. So now I want to use commands. What if you are not, but become an operator to do it faster? And right now I've made my brother also an operator, so he can also access the commands. Okay, so some of you were also saying that when you move over here, it says offline. It's offline because your server is not on. That's why I said you must be on before you can do this. Like, your server must be online. Alright, so now, apart from that, to also know the number of people, or to know, like, an easier way to know people, the people in your server and their connection or whatever, if you press in the tab key, you can see it on top over there. So I'm using this. So only two people on my server right now. I don't know what that's useful, but me, that's what I used to check if everyone is already on my server or the number of people I want is on my server. Okay, so now let's say someone is misbehaving on your server. All you do is you type in slash, then you type in kick, and when you type in kick, then you type in the name of the username. The name of the person you are kicking. So SM, that's the name he's using. Then I click it, then I press enter, then it says SM left the game and he should be joining in some. Okay, now he has joined back. So that's how you kick someone from your server when the person is maybe misbehaving. But there's also another way. So let's say the person is joining back after you kick him, he joins you, you know, you are doing a whole lot of things, then he's he's distracting you and stuff. So all you do is you type in slash ban. So this time you can ban his IP, but I won't do that. So he kicked me and I don't know why he's doing that, and if I get hold of him alright, so I'm joining back. I don't know why he also kicked me back, and he shouldn't worry, I'll be back. Okay, so also let's say you have a lot of things in your chat right now and you want to clear them, just type in F3 plus D, then it's clear your chat, and now you don't have anything in your chat, because I don't like it when I have a lot of things in my chat. Okay, then I want to ban him because he's also kicking me back. Now look at this, he killed me seriously. So for the kill, it's very easy, you just type in slash kill then the username. But I was teaching you the ban, but the ban IP, I don't try that. I only type in ban, then maybe his username. So you have banned him from the game and he can't come into the game again. I banned him. And let's say I want to bring him back. Instead of typing and ban, you can do it slash pardon then SM. Then now let's see when he'll join. So I'm sure by now he is not able to join because he has been banned and now he has joined back. So if you don't unban him, he can't get back into the game. And for this one, okay, so another one which is also going to help is the game rule command. So mostly when you're playing on, maybe for example, let's say survival, And you don't want your survival to be so difficult to the extent that when you die, your items get lost. Most of you know about this. You just type in game rule. Yeah, so you just type in game rule. Then you type in keep inventory. So right now, if I die, I won't... Okay, so now let's just get some items and let's try this to see if it works. So let me just get this and let me kill myself. So /kill, right? Okay, so I'm dead. And if I respawn, I should get my item. So why didn't I get it? Oh, okay, so I forgot something. Instead of typing that, you just type in game rule, keep inventory, then you type in true. So I didn't bring the true, that's why it killed me or something. Okay, so now the thing is true. Let's kill ourselves and I should respond with it. Still, it didn't work. How? I don't know. There is something I have to learn more about this, but for game, okay, so I have it back. So I think the game glitched. Okay, so it worked. And also, we have another one. So when you want to teleport the players to you, let's say you want to teleport your friend to you when you first join and maybe you can't find him, just type in, he just teleported himself to me. So you type in /tp at SM, that's him. And I teleport him and he's with me. And if you want to teleport him, you to him, then just type in TP, then your name and his username next. Then that's. But for teleporting all the players, for that one, I think I have to learn more about that. And I think that one is also possible. We can teleport all players to you. But yeah, I'll be showing you that if possible in another one, which is maybe part 3. And also the last one I can also show you is the difficulty. And if you want to change the difficulty, let's say you're going to do a build challenge and there are a lot of mobs and stuff, you just type in /difficulty, then peaceful, then now you are good to go. And yeah, your difficulty has been set to peaceful. So that's how to use this. Or maybe if you want to do this in creative and you're not, and yeah, so as I said again, if you want to use the commands, you must first become an operator. And if you are not using your own server to do this, then there is no way you can do this. So you must be having your own server and use the console. There's another way to access the console by using the run, which I have not learned much about that one, but this is the simplest one I can use for now, which is on the Atenos server. I'm sure other servers does this, but for the Atenos, this is how you do it. So it's a simple way you can do this. And what the hell is he doing? Okay, so yeah, I'll be showing you more and more on my server, and I'm building a city, so I'll be making a tour video. Not now, I'll let you guys know. It's a very cool one, but this is okay. No, not now, we'll not talk about it now. So yeah, so this is how we use some of the simple commands. I'll be making maybe a part 3 and some of the server commands you can access. And yeah, so when I'm done, I'll let you guys know. And I hope this video helped you. If you have any more questions on using the server, let me know in the comment section below and I'll make a video on it. I'll be so happy to do that. So thanks for watching guys, and thanks for subscribing, and I shall see you guys in the next one. Peace out.